Most people knew the late Steve Jobs as the face of Apple, but there was another man who stood back to back with him, Timothy Donald Cook. Without him, neither Apple nor the genius of the great Steve Jobs would have shone through. Cook's net worth has crossed $1 billion recently, something that is rare for a CEO who is not the founder of a company. Isn't it rare for a non-founder CEO to become a billionaire? Timothy Donald Cook was born in the small town of Robertsdale, Alabama, on November 1, 1960, the middle of three sons born to father Donald, a shipyard worker, and a mother Geraldine, a homemaker. Cook attended Robertsdale High School and graduated second in his class in 1978. After graduation, he was hired by IBM, where he moved up in ranks to become the corporation's North American Fulfillment Director following a 12-year career at IBM. Cook then went on to become the Chief Operating Officer of the Reseller Division at Intelligent Electronics, and after 3 years there, he joined the Compaq Computer Corporation as Vice President of Corporate Materials. He is an American business executive and also a philanthropist. The Alabama native had a humble start in life as a son of a shipyard worker and a pharmacy employee. He first began working for Apple in 1998, where Tim Cook remarked in a commencement address at Auburn University that 5 minutes into the interview with Jobs, he knew he wanted to join Apple. This was before the company had developed the iMac, iPod, iPhone, or iPad. Also at the time, Apple had seen declining profits instead of profit growth. According to Cook, prior to accepting his job at Apple, he was actually dissuaded from doing so on the grounds that the company's future looked very bleak. After a few years, Cook came on board as vice president, and with less than a year after his Apple debut, the corporation was reporting profits. As Cook rose to the position of executive vice president and then chief operating officer, he took responsibility for maintaining worldwide sales and operations. He also led the Macintosh division and continued development of the reseller-supplier relationship. Tim Cook had always been in charge of the general operations during Steve Jobs' absence. At Apple, Cook started out as a senior vice president of worldwide operating. He served as the interim CEO in 2009, while Steve Jobs was on a medical leave. In August 2011, Steve Jobs had written a letter addressing to those assembled, and in that he opened that he felt he wanted Tim Cook to take his place. Steve Jobs was also confident of him succeeding. He also added that Apple's best days were ahead of it, and he would serve as chairman. This made him the seventh Apple CEO, and as of writing, he has overseen the company for 8 years. Timothy Donald Cook was then named Apple's new CEO, taking over the position for former CEO and Apple co-founder Steve Jobs. Mr. Cook had joined one of the most elite clubs for CEOs who didn't actually found the companies they run. His net worth has eclipsed $1 billion, according to calculations. The club also includes former Microsoft chief executive Steve Ballmer, who was with the company from 1980 to 2014 and is the world's seventh richest person, with an estimated net worth of $75 billion. Apple's market value since then has been on the rise, following strong results and upbeat outlook for tech giants. Tim Cook's net worth estimate is based off the analysis of regulatory filing and sales. In addition to serving as CEO, Cook also sits on the corporation's board of directors. 9 years after Steve Jobs stepped down and thrust Tim Cook to the top of Apple Incorporated, the company is more valuable than ever. In 2014, Cook unveiled the iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus, both of which had larger screen sizes and came with new features such as Apple Play and burst selfies. He also continued to oversee the development of new products like Clips. A few months after the spring of 2017, Apple unveiled the iPhone X, which generated quite a buzz in the tech world for its innovative facial recognition technology. In November 2011, Cook was named one of Forbes magazine's World's Most Powerful People, and in 2012, Cook was the highest paid CEO among large public traded companies. While Cook is more visibly engaged with politics and security debates, he does continue to remain a particularly private individual. After all, he is instantly recognizable. He's still very much the face of Apple instead of a celebrity in his own right. And that's when in 2015, he announced that after paying for his nephew's college education, he would donate the rest of his fortune to philanthropic projects, and also that he plans to give most of his fortune away and has already gifted millions of dollars worth of Apple shares. He's thrown fundraisers for politicians that include former President Barack Obama and former presidential candidate and Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. Equally as important as managing a process that prevented stockpiling was Apple's need to predict sales. Well, we're now familiar with Apple selling out of devices on launch day, and that is as much about the benefit of advertising its success as it is saying the prediction failed. Nonetheless, that prediction of demand is treated so seriously that there is an entire department at Apple that works on it. The current head of retail, Deidre O'Brien, was instrumental in the demand prediction for much of 3 decades at Apple. And guess what? It isn't just about guessing how many 5G iPhones will be sold. It's about knowing what technology Apple will need and when. Under Tim Cook, and with the benefit of greater financial stability, Apple would make the very unusual step of making very long-term investments in technology, such as a flash memory. Consequently, Cook's work in streamlining and growing Apple became very well known in the industry. But it wasn't until 2009 that he really became anything of a public figure. The vast majority of Tim Cook's estimated wealth comes from the equity awards he's received since joining Apple in 1998, where he has drawn applause for mastering the company's complex supply chain. Cook currently holds 847,969 Apple shares, which at the current stock price are worth more than $380 million, which makes up a tiny 0.02% stake in the company. Proceeds from the previous share sales, dividends, and other compensations add another $650 million to his net worth. The 59-year-old has presided over a more than 8-fold increase in Apple share prices since the takeover, but from about $53 in 2011 to more than $450 in 2019, Cook's compensation package includes a $3 million base salary and around $7.6 million in incentive pay, making him one of the highest paid CEOs in the United States. Apple was valued at about $350 billion when Tim Cook stepped up from Chief Operating Officer to replace Steve Jobs. And now, Apple has become the world's first publicly listed company to be worth over $2 trillion. According to the report, Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla, is the highest paid CEO across the globe, with over $595 million made during the last year. However, when it comes to tech industry, Apple's Tim Cook is one of the highest paid CEOs in the industry. Tim Cook made more than $133 million during the last year. This indicates that he is the second highest paid CEO around the world. Both as an individual and as a CEO, Cook has been far more outspoken politically than any of his predecessors. Where Jobs may have perhaps have cultivated the public perception of him as the face of Apple, Cook has directly presented himself as such an over-issue ranging from privacy and security to sexuality. Cook's leadership skills is known to be both effective and democratic. He is known to be quiet and mild-mannered, and he helps employees focused and driven by berating them with an abundance of questions designed to ensure that they will understand the task so they honor their responsibilities in a timely and well-executed manner. He is a hugely influential player in the technology, design, publishing, and entertainment, although Apple Music is still trailing behind Spotify. Did you know Tim Cook even sits on the board of Nike as well? As well as on the board of trustees of Duke. The head of the tech giant prefers a frugal lifestyle, encourages his company to support philanthropy, and plans to give away everything when he dies. Tim Cook's best-known hobby is his love of fitness, hiking, and cycling. As for travel, Tim Cook has to travel often for work. And Apple has spent around $93,109 last year on Cook's private plane alone. A 4 a.m. riser, Cook is known to be a compulsive worker with a zealot-like dedication to Apple. Cook's first meeting with employees the day he joined back in 1998 lasted 11 hours. His weekly meeting with operations and finance employees has been nicknamed Date Night with Tim because it runs well into the evening. He is fundamentally a nice guy, and in interviews comes across as candid if not reserved. In fact, if you did not know about him, I bet you could meet him on the streets of Palo Alto and think he was about par for the course in terms of affordability in that region. But he is pragmatic in the way that many intelligent, self-made, low-key businessmen are. And that's it for today's video. Don't forget to give this video a like. Also, subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.